The Maryland Department of Juvenile Services continues to improve its policies and the way it provides treatment and services to youth. After analyzing data over the years, DJS found that the length of time youth were spending in residential treatment facilities was not closely related to the intensity of their treatment needs. Many other states across the country have demonstrated successful outcomes with the implementation of a new data-driven model that is based on treatment hours and increased youth and family involvement. Research suggests that keeping youth in out of home placement longer doesn't reduce crime. What works is when programs focus on making sure youth in need of services receive the right services for the right amount of time in a high-quality program that looks at risk, need, treatment, and fidelity. Using the concept of dosage, DJS length of stay policy will be updated to better match length of treatment to a youth's level of need and ensure that evidence-based services target the needs that led to a youth's justice involvement. The new model will enhance the youth's experience within the residential facilities and increase their success in the community. The new policy will also improve racial and ethnic disparities. It will be equitable, fair, therapeutic, collaborative, individualized, and developmentally appropriate. When staff work collectively with youth and their families and listen to their voices, youth are more likely to have successful outcomes. By changing the length of stay policy, one step at a time, DJS youth can meet their individualized treatment goals and see their progress toward returning home to their families. Successful treatment and integration into the community is our goal. This will be an ongoing process, but focused on a data-driven model and research. Change is good, and now is the time for DJS youth to benefit from the change. DJS, collaboration, data-driven, successful outcomes.